So stage two patients are those individuals where their cancer is found to invade into the wall but has not gotten into the lymph nodes. And this is a controversial area in terms of what we should do after they've undergone a potentially curative surgery. Should we give them chemotherapy? Now, in general, it's about 80% of patients that are cured and 20% of patients that are still at risk. That may be acceptable to some folks, but for us, we want to try to cure everybody. So how do we improve upon those numbers, especially that 20%? We know that chemotherapy given to stage three patients provides about a 33% benefit. So arguably of that 20%, we can divide that by three. We push another six or seven patients into the cured group. The limitation with that is that we have to treat everybody to get that extra six patients into the cured group. So is there any test or any way to pre-evaluate that and identify who the patients are? And I think we've done great work in trying to identify this, and it's actually something we talked about earlier, the microsatellite instability, the defective mismatch repair that underlies the hereditary non-polyposis colorectal cancer genetic syndrome, Lynch syndrome. So what does that all mean? There are specific DNA repair enzymes that are defective. This leads to abnormalities throughout the genome, throughout the cancer genes that are what we call microsatellites. These genes are unstable, they're mutated. This raises the risk for colon cancer before the age of 50, but it also paradoxically leads to improved prognosis. So you have a better prognosis even though you're at risk for developing colon cancer. Moving on into the context of treatment in the stage two patient, this marker, there was concern early on that patients that had this marker were going to be resistant to chemotherapy, for example, to 5-FU, 5-fluorouracil, a drug that is the backbone of some of our chemotherapy combinations. This was supported in the lab, and some data became available that suggested that patients with this marker do not benefit from this specific chemotherapy. So this is the chemotherapy that we give stage two patients, and here we have the potential that they're not going to benefit. So I think the conclusion is if you have what they call microsatellite instability high, MSI, or defective mismatch repair, you have a good prognosis, you have potential harm from chemotherapy, and for all those reasons, I think that what we do now is we observe these patients and we do not subject them to chemotherapy. So I think that's the best answer that we have. We would not treat these individuals. We would just observe them because their prognosis is so good. Other tests for stage two patients are being developed. One of them is the Oncotype DX test. It's a very important test. It's been validated, numerous series, large databases. And basically what it tells us is that if you have a T4 lesion in the colon, that's a tumor that's invaded through the wall and is starting to invade other structures in the abdomen. If you have that type of lesion, and I think we already knew this, you need to receive chemotherapy. As we said earlier, if you have microsatellite instability, MSI high, we would not treat you. But in the middle of those curves is what we call the T3N0 patients, about 74%. And the Oncotype DX test enables us to have either a low risk, intermediate risk, or high risk group identified. And in my practice, I tend to treat high risk patients. The low and the intermediate risk groups, I would not treat.